Hey guys, what's up? It's Vittensby the StarCraft 2 Dude back with another strategy commentary for you guys. Today we're going to be looking at the Swarm of Upgraded Speed Zergling strategy that I've been using lately on ladder. This is good against the standard 7 to 8 minute Roach Speed Zergling timing attacks or all-in variants. To start, we're going to be getting the 9 supply, up to 9 supply with our drones. There are still some people that don't know what that is. If you're new, 9 simply refers to the supply. Then we'll be getting our Overlord. And this build is actually very similar in its start to the 7 to 8 minute Roach Speedling timing attack or all-ins. You will be getting your 13 extractor as well as a 13 spawning pool. And you'll notice in the production tab that the timings of our pool and gas are basically the same. But the difference is what comes after that. And your general idea is you want to get 350 gas as soon as possible, because this 350 gas will allow you to get your metabolic boost upgrade. It will also allow you to get your weapon upgrade from one of your evolution chambers, and then the other evolution chamber will be getting your armor upgrade. And what that does for you is it basically makes all of your zerglings super zerglings, that they'll be able to take out any roach or zergling opposition that comes to you or anything that goes from you to them. It's a really strong build. The only real counters that I've seen have been people that go for a quick baneling build, but you can rely on this. It's pretty safe, and if you do encounter banelings, what you want to do is use the spine crawler, which you'll be seeing in just a second being placed down, and kite around your zerg drones so that you don't get blown up in the early game by banelings. So, as you can see here, we're going to be dropping a 14 or 15 double evolution chamber. That's so you can get your two upgrades at the same time. And this is an adaptation of the 1-0 speedling build. And this will counter that build pretty good. So it's a nice all-around strategy that you can use in ladder. And at this point, you will be getting, you know, somewhere around a 15 or 16 crawler. Your timings may vary on this, and I have recently decided to push back the timing of the second evolution chamber just a bit, because you can't get that much gas. Now you see I did get my metabolic boost and my queen both at the same time. That's around, again, 15 supply. You'll also want to get an extra overlord somewhere around this time. Now, really, I've chosen to focus on the armor first. Because the reason for that is because roaches will basically take, I believe, one less hit to take out your zerglings. And you need to, if they do get the attack upgrade, which is pretty common with that strategy, you can squeeze in, you know, 100 gas here or there and drop an evolution chamber as well. So I do go with the armor upgrade first, because it allows your zerglings to have extra survivability. And that also means a lot up going up against other zerglings. So you see that my second evolution chamber in this particular replay is kind of sitting there, not really doing a whole lot. So as an adaptation, I would say probably wait a little while longer to put your second evolution chamber down, because you just won't have the gas income. And, you know, try to line up all three of those upgrades at the same time. I mean, because the reason is because you're not going to really be pumping out speedlings until you're around this supply, around 22 supply, 24 supply. And it's important to note that your expansion will be really well saturated. And at that point, when you have around 22 drones or 20 supply of drones, 20 to 24, you'll want to stop gas altogether. Once you get the three upgrades going, I should have mentioned that basically getting those three upgrades, once they're starting, take all your guys off gas and try to get the gas counter. You'll notice in the upper right hand corner I have 14. Try to make that zero. You want to line it up perfectly. At this point in the game, around 6 minutes and 30 seconds, I would recommend, this is something you're not seeing in this particular replay, but more recently I've decided to adapt and add an extra queen or two, because right here, this is the point right here, 300 minerals, and you're going to begin to float just a little bit. So getting an extra queen or two, maybe laying down a creep tumor, it's pretty nice. I think this is kind of like more of a baiting strategy. You want your opponent to go on the offense, or if they're, you know, in transition to, you know, moving across the map, it's really nice that you can intercept that, get a nice surround, and your Zerglings are going to do tremendous amounts of damage. So other than the two extra queens, I mean, the second hatch is really important because you just don't have the amount of larva that you need right now in order to be able to spend those extra resources. And you're going to see just how quickly here that these speed Zerglings just absolutely chew through roaches. You can see that right there with just one attack upgrade. But with the extra armor upgrade, it helps out with the Zerglings. And I'm going to go ahead and stop the replay right here because basically I run into his base and take him out. And he's kind of not expecting that either. So let's just go ahead and speed that up. We'll change the vision to everyone and you can kind of see how this is going to end. Typical of the timing attack, they do expand. It's not a speedling expand. It's the roach speedling timing on that. It's very, very standard at 7 minutes. So take it easy. Thanks for watching, and I hope that you check out the other replays in my How to Win Zerg versus Zerg strategy commentaries.